Alright guys, well I had every intention of making another fly tying video today. I even had the fly picked out, but I fished all day yesterday. I fished all day Friday, and frankly I was kind of beat today. So when I set out to go start getting everything together for making the video, my fly tying station was an absolute disaster, and I kind of got distracted. Started putting stuff away, and then I made the ultimate decision that I was just going to do a thorough cleaning. And as I was doing that, I thought maybe it would be cool to do like a cribs style, this is my fly tying area video. As you can see, my tying area is out here in my living room. We have a pretty small house, and a couple years ago, I used to have my desk stuffed in my bedroom, and a couple years ago my wife decided that she would like to bring it out here, which really surprised me. But once we got it set up, it actually made a lot of sense, because now when I'm tying flies, I'm not locked away in the bedroom. I'm out here in the living room where with the family, and so we can watch some movies, my wife can watch her TV shows, whatever, and I can be tying flies and still engaging in conversation and be present, and so it kind of works out. It isn't ideal. It's a pretty cramped little space. I certainly don't have my own room or anything massive, but it works for me and the tying that I do. So I have no complaints. So to start off with, I'm going to take a look at the storage. I've got a pretty fancy system set up here. As you can plainly see, I've got some really, really fancy buckets they're like drawer things from this real high class place called Walmart, and they're pretty expensive, but they work. And I take in my wife's labeler and went nuts one day and labeled everything in the world that I could, mainly to make my wife happy. I'm so unorganized, that's not something that I would ordinarily do, but my wife was pretty cool with it. You can see, got some other goodies here. I use the smaller one for random odds and ends. This is, I've got some like syringes and some extra clear cure goo and whatnot. Just random tools, paint pens. I usually keep Sharpies in here. The little parts that come with the vices, Allen wrenches and things. Here's all my tubes. Micro tubing or junction tubing and rigid tubes for tying on. I keep my tube fly adapter in here. Over here I've got a pile of flies waiting to go on the dash of the truck. These are all ones that have been retired. I've got this is just a bunch of junk flies, flies that are on their fish, flies that are screwed up. Every once in a while I'll go through there and dig something out. I've been known to cut off dumbbell eyeballs off of certain flies when I run out and I don't want to make a run to the store, and it works. Here I've got a little my scrap material bucket. If ever I have something that, I'm done with it, but I have a few inches left of chenille or dubbing or, flat braid, whatever, I throw it in here. It's kind of handy when I run out of something. I can often dig through here and find what I need to, at least tie up a few flies. Here I've got the old, this is the Orvis fly tying drying station. It's pretty fancy. I use this for drying stinger flies, usually. Got the obligatory lamp putting towards the vise. I've got Rob's 8-weight lamps and line and reels sitting here waiting to give it back to him. So I haven't forgot about you, Rob, just waiting on the vise to come back. Got the old picture from a long, long time ago before I knew about the state of wild steelhead. I caught 24 and a 21-pound steelhead that day. That was pretty epic. So moving on here, we got the smaller drawers. You can see got just all kinds of beads, cone heads, dumbbell eyes, adhesive eyes. This is just where I keep all that good stuff. Next we got bunny, rabbit strips. Big fan of all this. Deer and elk hair. I don't use a whole lot, but I do a little bit here and there, so I like to have stash tied and hand on hand. This drawer here is one that gets used an awful lot. This is chenilles and body wrap materials. Got lots of Estaz. I'm a huge fan of Estaz. Got the polar chenille. This stuff is freaking great. Micro UV polar chenille. We got craft store finds. Just all anything that I would use to wrap a body goes in that drawer. It's getting pretty full. Here I got random hooks. I need to kind of clean this out a little bit. All my big hooks, you know, 6-aught ling cod, big old Siwash hooks. Got the 3-aught, some little jig hooks. These are just kind of odds and ends. 3-aught OU401s, these are real nice, tight ocean Chinook patterns on those. 8-aught octopus hooks, 6-aught octopus hooks, all my, basically most of my big stuff for ling cod and Chinook and things like that. Got dubbing. I don't do that much with dubbing. I got a bunch of ice dubbing in here. It's kind of my favorite for saltwater flies, but I got a few other odds and ends. Moving on down, we got the bigger drawers. Got synthetics in this one. Everything from Senyo Predator Wrap. I got craft fur in here. I guess it's not totally a synthetic. Steve Farrar blend. Got a lot of that. Just all kinds of synthetic materials for saltwater flies. Super hair. Next is flash. Some people will probably cringe at this drawer. This is pretty terrible. Tons and tons of crystal flash, especially chartreuse pink. Polar flash, big fan of that. You know, the essentials. I'm not very good at staying organized with this stuff. Oh, here we go. Here we got the DNA holochromosome flash. I don't think you can even see that, but this stuff is my favorite. Then we got the all-important drawer for any saltwater fly fisher, the bucktail. And I got a whole slew of bucktails of all colors. Constantly buying bucktail. This drawer smells like an animal. Marabou, another real important one. I got, you know, every color imaginable for the tying the saltwater flies. And then I got, this is just a drawer, this is all my hackle and feathers. A lot of this came from a buddy of mine, Chris, sent me a whole bunch of materials. Really great stuff. Golden pheasant, Lady Amherst for tying squimps, all kinds of saddle hackle, schlappen. I even got some long, these are for tying flat wings, which I haven't delved into a whole lot yet, but I've got all the stuff here since, so I might as well, one of these days I'll give that a shot. Moving on to the desk itself, this is nothing fancy. This is just I believe I got this at Walmart, you know, one of those pre-assembled or assemble yourself ones. Not much for storage. It's got a drawer there, a couple shelves. I have some treasured things in here. I have a letter that Mr. Roger Stevens sent me I don't remember how many years ago. Roger Stevens is something of a sea-run cutthroat fishing icon as far as I'm concerned, and when I bought my first boat, he sent me this handwritten letter about how he set his boat up and some tips and tricks, and I just thought that was really awesome, and I've saved that. And this is another personal little treasure of mine. There's a guy by the name of Sean West. He's a fly tier. He ties at a lot of the shows. He posts on Washington Fly Fishing. That's where I've seen him. And he ties the most amazing deer hair poppers that I have ever seen. And I've always admired them and commented on them when he posts. And just incredible. And it was about this time last year, I think, he sent me a private message and asked for my address. And a little while later, here came a box of these flies, and I mean, these things are just incredible. I haven't fished any of these yet. I want to try some out for saltwater, but they're so freaking cool that I have a hard time thinking about fishing them. And you know, just the fact that he sent me these, I know these are not easy to tie, they take time, and man, he sent me, you know what, seven of these, and I just thought that was awesome, and so I keep it here, and I like to just look at them, but one of these days I'll actually go and fish them. I think these would work in the salt around here. But if you ever watch this, Sean, thank you so much, man. These are just truly one of my favorite possessions. Got the big spool with the holder here. My wife picked that up for me at a craft store somewhere. Keep all my threads, tinsels, you know. Got some body braid type material on there. Anything that comes on a spool goes there. I need to set up my other one here somewhere because I'm getting too many threads. Here I got some head cements and UV resins and all that good stuff. Quite a while I've used Clear Cure Goo. Comes in these syringes, so I always keep it in the cup so as I don't make a mess. But here just recently, just the other day, I got this Loon UV Clear Fly Finish. This is the thick. I just tied with this night before last for the first time, and I think I might do a little review video for it. Pretty decent stuff. Sally Hansen's, love this stuff. I go through this stuff by the gallon. It's my favorite for just head cement. I use it on my clousers, just anything I want to add for durability. Of course, I got the Zap Gap. Use that for certain applications, putting on adhesive eyeballs sometimes. Little red handled pliers on my barb pinchers. Use those right before I put any hook in the vise. These are just the tools that I keep out. All my pairs of scissors, these rising scissors here, they've kind of become my favorite recently. You can adjust the tension on them, and they're super sharp. I really like this open loop style. These are really cheap, but they're great scissors. I tend to use these ones for cutting hairs and wires and heavier things. And of course, the Dr. Slicks. I got quite a few pairs of these around. I wear them out, but they're not terribly expensive, so I just pick up a new one. Keep four bobbins pretty much rigged and ready at all times. I have some more, but these are the ones I use primarily. I like this. These are both the adjustable style. This is a Stonfo. These are the saltwater larger ones. And then I got the Wright bobbins, which I really like those too. You can adjust the thread tension on both. Of course, the vise. I got the Dynaking Barracuda. I've used every vise imaginable, and this has just become my favorite. I tied on this for several years, and then a little over a year ago, I bought a Regal Revolution, and I sold this to my buddy Rob, same guy who's got the reel sitting here. And I tied on the Regal for a year, and I just decided that I wanted to go back to the Dynaking. You can see mainly, my biggest thing is I tie huge hooks, and even with the big game jaws on the Regal, it wasn't quite as good at holding like A-dot hooks. But the biggest thing I like is the room behind the vise, the head here for my fat hands when I'm working with long tails, and which I do a lot of. So recently me and Rob made a swap back. I had to send my Regal in for some warranty work. I'm waiting to hear back from it, and as soon as I do, I'll be giving that and the reel back over to Rob. He had decided that he didn't tie on this vise all that much after he bought it from me, so it was a good fit to just swap back. I appreciated it. Great vise. Nothing holds a hook better than this. Absolutely nothing I found. Over here, this is where I got a little tub here. I keep just random hooks. I actually went through this not that long ago, so there's not that many of them. You know, as I'm going about tying, I'm always switching from one fly to another, one hook size to another, and oftentimes, you know, I'll end up with a hook here and there. In fact, there's one that's hidden. It escaped my cleaning right there. So I just started tossing them in here instead of trying to like put them back in their package or where I keep them, because just gives me a little stash for when I'm like running low, run out of something, I want to tie a fly, and I just dig through there and usually I can find what I need. Big bunch of toothpicks. I use that a lot when I'm working with any sort of the UV resins. I'll use that to just kind of shape it and whatever. I keep my most used hooks in these two little bin containers. I've got one for sea run cutthroat flies and one for salmon flies. That's basically just sizes. C15 size 6s, SC15 size 4s, got the Umpqua U401 6s and 8s, Tiemco 811s, that says size 8 but those are 6s. I got some Daiichi 2546s. Salmon box, I've got all kinds of barbless Gamagatsu octopus hooks. Size 1s are my standard. I use those for all my coho clousers. Got some 1/0s when I want to go bigger. Got size 2 if I want to go smaller. Got some Umpqua U401 1/0s. I tie a lot of Chinook patterns and ocean patterns on those. I got Tiemco 811s size 4s. Generally tie chum flies on those. I have tied some sea run cutthroat flies on them lately. Shanks, these are the ones that I use for my stinger clousers. These are generally mustad. What the heck are those? 47007s or 34007 DTs, whatever. Cheap hooks that I'll cut the point off when I get done. More barbless gummy, yes. These are the clear ones, size ones. Swear by those hooks. Just a little thing that my son made me when he was in like a wood chop class. Over here we got a little more storage. Got Fireline. This is what I use for my stinger hooks. I'm getting real low on that. I need to make a run. I got a line here I need to send back to Eric. Eric, I'll get this back to you. I'm so lazy and I forget this. The Rio 7-weight striper intermediate line he let me borrow to try out on a rod. Of course, I've always got spools of Maxima laying around. I got this digital picture frame for Christmas a few years ago, and we couldn't decide what to do with it, and I had a light bulb moment. I thought, I'm going to put that on my tying desk, and I'm just going to put all kinds of fishing pictures on it, and it's pretty cool. So when I'm sitting here tying flies, I'll turn it on and I can have memories kind of flashing back and gives me some inspiration. There's Ira with his one coho that he caught that day. Should ask him about that one. My mom got us this for Christmas a few years ago. Thanks, Mom. Makes a great addition to my tying desk. I really like just sitting here. Sometimes I'll get distracted and just sit there and watch fish pictures. For coming down, I still got some more storage. Another one of these smaller bins. I got some squirrel tail, more Fireline in here. Peacock hurl. I can't even remember what this is. Arctic fox, I think. Just a few random odds and ends. This one's got all tools in it. And some pink head cement that I've had forever and never really used. Use the dykes. I use those for clipping the shanks on stinger hooks. Older scissors, more scissors, dubbing wax, I don't use that too much. Stole one of these from my wife for when I'm using like certain materials, rabbit and a dubbing loop or something I want to line up and put in a dubbing loop. Wire strippers, I don't know what on earth I use those for. Nail knot tool, razor blades, hackle pliers, dubbing needle, bodkin, whatever you want to call that. Little tool for brushing out dubbing, scissors, the usual kind of stuff. In here I have more kind of odds and ends. I got all my like crazy legs, fly foam for tying gurglers and things. I got ice dub shimmer fringe in here. Bait fish emulator. This stuff is pretty cool. I use this for bigger saltwater flies. It's a ice dub shimmer fringe. This is the herring back, I believe. Yeah, this stuff is pretty freaking cool. I really, really have become a big fan of that in the last few years. dug out the foam, the rippled foam from a couple of old beat up fly boxes, and used some 3M adhesive stick on things to stick them to the wall so I don't damage the wall paint or anything. But use those for when I'm tying flies. I stick them up there to dry, regular flies anyway, not the stinger flies. This other one is just kind of turned into a odds and ends of experimental flies and things that but it's kind of nice. I just stick them right up on the wall right in front of me and let them dry, and then transfer them into the fly box. So that kind of sums up my little tying area. It generally is not this clean. Before I cleaned up this morning, it was a freaking disaster area. I could not find anything, and like I said, I ended up started putting a few things away, got distracted, and just decided I was just going to clean the whole shebang and go for it. So here it is set up. This is kind of how it looks when I don't tie flies. I don't know. I think it's kind of pointless, but my wife likes it, and it looks kind of cool. It kind of blends in with the rest of the house. So there you have it. That's just my little piece of heaven here where I get it. So thanks for watching. I'll get back to my regular fly tying videos. Maybe I'll try to knock one out tonight, but if not tonight, then definitely tomorrow, unless I go fishing, which is a possibility.